Good morning, brothers and sisters. I'm very happy to announce to you that starting September 20th, Sunday, September 20th, we will reopen the 7 a.m. Mass in the church with a limited capacity of 100. Okay? And after the 7 o'clock Mass, we'll come back here to continue with the rest of the Masses for Sunday. But Sunday, that September the 20th, we'll start with 7 a.m. Mass in the church. Okay? If you have any questions, please call us at the office. We're getting everything organized and the church ready. So by Sunday, the 20th, we'll start at 7 a.m. Mass in the church. Only that would be the only Mass in our parish, the 7 o'clock Mass, okay?
Of God, gather us, amor de Dios haz nos uno, that we may share the gifts we are given, para construir la comunidad, para construir la comunidad. In the living water, we have become one body in the Lord. O love of God, gather us, amor de Dios haz nos uno, that we may share the gifts we are given, para construir la comunidad, para construir la comunidad.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
It is the Saturday of the 22nd week. Today, usually we celebrate the memorial of our Blessed Mother Mary on Saturday. But on this fifth day of September, I want us to celebrate today, as we've been directed by the Universal Church, the memorial of Saint Mother Teresa of Calcutta. We remember the successes that God had used her to accomplish in the life of many people, especially the poor around the world. And we ask for her intercession today as we remember her, that she may also pray for us to be strong ambassadors of Christ in whatever capacity we find ourselves. In this Mass, we pray for the repose of the soul of Felicitas Valerio and for the special intention of Cara and Greg Collins and family. Let us now take a moment in our hearts, acknowledge our sins, and ask God for pardon and mercy. Lord, have mercy. Christ, have mercy. Lord, have mercy. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to life everlasting. Amen. Let us pray. O God, who in your saints have given an example and brought us protection in our weakness to help us tread the path of salvation, mercifully grant that we who honor the heavenly birthday of Mother Teresa of Calcutta may through her example make our way to you, our God. We make this prayer through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever. Amen. Please be seated.
A reading from the first letter of St. Paul to the Corinthians. Brothers and sisters, learn from myself and Apollos not to go beyond what is written, so that none of you will be inflated with pride in favor of one person over another. Who confers distinction upon you? What do you possess that you have not received? But if you have received it, why are you boasting as if you did not receive it? Are you already satisfied? You have already grown rich. You have become kings without us. Indeed, I wish that you had become kings so that we also might become kings with you. For I see it, God has exhibited as apostles as the last of all, like people sentenced to death. Since we have become a spectacle to the world, to angels and men alike. We are fools on Christ's account, but you are wise in Christ. We are weak, but you are strong. You are held in honor, but we in disrepute. To this very hour, we go hungry and thirsty. We are poorly clad and roughly treated. We wander about homeless and we toil, working with our own hands. When ridiculed, we bless. When persecuted, we endure. When slandered, we respond gently. We have become like the world's rubbish, the scum of all, to this very moment. I am writing you this not to shame you, but to admonish you as my beloved children. Even if you should have countless guides to Christ, yet you do not have many fathers. For I became your father in Christ Jesus through the gospel. The word of the Lord. The Lord is near to all who call upon him. The Lord is near to all who call upon him. The Lord is just in all his ways and holy in his works. The Lord is near to all who call upon him, to all who call upon him in truth. The Lord is near to all who call upon him. He fulfills the desire of those who fear him. He hears their cry and saves them. The Lord keeps all who loves him, but all the wicked he will destroy. The Lord is near to all who call upon him. My mouth speaks the praise of the Lord. And all my flesh bless his holy name forever and ever. The Lord is near to all who call upon him.
Says the Lord, no one comes to the Father except through me. Alleluia, 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 alleluia.
The Lord be with you. A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Luke. While Jesus was going through a field of grain on a Sabbath, his disciples were picking the heads of grain, rubbing them in their hands and eating them. Some Pharisees said, "Why are you doing what is unlawful on the Sabbath?" Jesus said to them in reply, "Have you not read what David did when he and those who were with him were hungry? How he went into the house of God, took the bread of offering, which only the priests could lawfully eat, ate of it, and shared it with his companions?" Then he said to them, "The Son of Man is Lord of the Sabbath." The Gospel of the Lord. Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ. Once again, welcome as we honor and celebrate the memorial of Saint Mother Teresa of Calcutta. She is the saint of our time because a number of us may have met her in person. And some of us, a number of others, could have also read about her or heard her story. Here was a poor nun who became popular because of her acts of charity. She was born in Albania, but later relocated to India because of need to take care of, to provide succor to underserved people, sick, orphaned, elderly, and people who were challenged by a number of human discomforts. On this Memorial Day of Saint Mother Teresa of Calcutta, Saint Paul writes to the Corinthians, and I see so much in that reading from the first letter to the Corinthians, chapter 4, beginning from verse 6 to 15, so much of what captured the life of Mother Teresa of Calcutta. Paul was a little upset with a situation that he was responding to in that reading. But above everything he had said, he remarked how he had become like weak so as to make others strong. How he was held in disrepute so that others can be held in honor. Because that captured what Mother Teresa did in her life among the underserved, undeserved people of Calcutta in India and around. Paul said he went hungry and thirsty. He was poorly clad and roughly treated, wandered around about homeless, toiling and working with his hands. This is just the story of Mother Teresa. And here was a woman who, towards the end of her life, had accumulated a number of honors from world leaders and international bodies and organizations because she stood out as an example of what we can be. From the life of Mother Teresa, we learn a few things, especially from her writings and a few of the things she had said very commonly. She understands that not many of us can do great things, but that we, all of us, can always do small things in great ways. She wasn't aiming at something up there in the sky. She went very, very down. Very down to the poorest of the poor. There is always something we can do for the poor. Because our own story is different. Because at least many of us, all of us at least, have roof over our head. Because we have qualifications that can give us some job to do and some living. But there are people who haven't these advantages. And they waste away, sometimes unrecognized. Mother Teresa was there to restore dignity, the dignity of the human person, to individuals who were underserved and underprivileged. From Mother Teresa, we also learn that it is not so much what we do. It is not so much what we do, but how much love we put in the things we do. In the job you do you take it as simply a career? What effort do you make to transform that job as an opportunity of service to God and the entire humanity? Are you able to bring so much love and laughter into your life and into the life of people you interact with so as to make a difference and make impact that is positive? My dear friends, these are a few of the things we can learn from the life of this woman. She made herself accessible to the underserved and the underprivileged. And today, September 5, every year, the church commemorates her memorial. I'm happy to welcome all of us. As we join in prayers, let us take from her example. Let us imitate her, because she imitated Christ, so that in working together, in bringing ourselves together, in putting love in what we do, we can make our actions something that is beautiful for God and be able to change not just our lives, but the lives of others. And by so doing, bring glory and honor to God as well as salvation for ourselves. trusting that the Lord is near to all who call on him, we give voice to our prayers this day.
That God may continue to bless his church with holy and sacrificial servants. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That the Son of Man, Jesus, Lord of the Sabbath, may deliver the whole world from the evils that around it. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That the Lord may be pleased to shower his tender compassion upon those who are hungry or marred in poverty. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That God's bountiful love may help members of this faith community heal any division in our families, our relationships. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That those who have died in Christ may inherit with him the riches of the kingdom. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
And for Felicita Valero, and for Cara and Greg Collins and family, for whom this Mass is offered, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer. We humbly bring our petitions to you, hoping that you would hear and answer these prayers as we pray through Christ our Lord. Amen.
Immaculate Mary, your praises we sing. You reign now in heaven with Jesus our King. Ave, Ave, Ave Maria. Ave, Ave Maria. In heaven the blessed your glory proclaim. On earth we your children invoke your fair name. Ave, Ave, Ave Maria. Ave, Ave Maria.
Pray, dear friends, that your sacrifice and mine may be acceptable to God the Father Almighty. And Lord, receive the sacrifice at your hand for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and the good of all his holy church. Through the present oblation, O Lord, which we offer in commemoration of Saint Teresa of Calcutta, bestow on your faithful, we pray, the gifts of unity and peace. Through Christ our Lord. The Lord be with you. Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is right and just. It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ our Lord. For in the marvelous confession of your sins, you make your church fruitful with strength ever new. And you offer us sure signs of your love, and that your saving mysteries may be fulfilled. Their great example lends us courage. Their fervent prayers sustains us in all we do. And so, Lord, with all the angels and saints, we too give you thanks, as in exaltation we acclaim. Holy, holy, holy Lord, God of hosts, Heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest. You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread, and giving thanks, broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it. For this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith. We proclaim your death, O Lord, and profess your resurrection until you come again. Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly, we pray that partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, Robert, John, and Ramon, our bishops, and all the clergy. Remember our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, Blessed Joseph, our spouse, with the blessed apostles and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him and with him and in him, O God Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. Amen. At the Savior's command, my dear friends, and formed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be your name. Your kingdom come, your will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever. Lord Jesus Christ, who say to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you," look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever. Amen. The peace of the Lord be with you always. May we share with one another the sign of peace. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, grant us peace. Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are we who are invited to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say your word, and my soul shall be healed. May the body and blood of Christ bring us to life everlasting. Our brothers joining us online can make their spiritual communion at this time. Let us pray. May the sacrament we receive, O Lord, in commemoration of Saint Mother Teresa of Calcutta, sanctify our minds and hearts, that we may merit to be made sharers in the divine nature, through Christ our Lord. Amen. The Lord be with you. May Almighty God bless us, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen. As we now receive Jesus in the Eucharist, let us go in his peace and love. Thanks be to God. Please don't forget to return your seat to its original position if you moved it. Please, please, don't forget. Get the seat back to the original position it was at the beginning of Mass to help us keep the seats, you know, respecting the 6 feet, something approximately, social distancing rule. Eucharistic ministers, please. Thank you.
Salve Regina, Mater Misericordiae, Vita Dulcedo, et Spes Nostra Salve. A te clamamus, exules filii Eve, a te suspiramus, gementes et flentes, in hac lacrimarum vale. Eia ergo, advocata nostra, illos tuos misericordes oculos a nos converte. Et Iesum, benedictum fructum ventris tui, nobis post hoc exilium ostende. O clemens, O pia, o dulcis Virgo Maria.